But summer could take some lessons from us.
Thank you, folks. Welcome to Voices of the Valley. I'm your host, Nancy Kennedy. And today I have with me genuine royalty. I'm very honored because this never happened to, I don't think, to Channel 6 before. Has it, JR? Never have. We've never had royalty before, but today I have two lovely ladies, royal ladies. One is a world's champion, and the other one is a recent champion. Is that correct, girls?
Yes.
Yes. To my left here is Bonnie Kelso, who is the world champion beer stein carrier for Oktoberfest. Is that correct? This is Bonnie Kelso. I've known her forever. And on my right is another beautiful girl by the name of Andrea Bill, who is captain of
the Sierra Belle.
The Sierra Belle on our lake. So I have royalty, you see, folks. I have two queens with me today. Shall we start with the world champion first?
Absolutely.
Okay. Bonnie Kelso. I don't think there's too many people up here that don't know you. But of the five or six that don't, please tell them about yourself.
Okay.
Your life history, you know how that goes.
I was born in Kansas. And my folks moved here when I was 2 years old, and we lived in Bell, California. Went all the way through school, Bell, California, or Bell High. Moved up here early 1970.
That's when I met you, I think. I'm pretty sure.
I loved it up here, and I have four lovely children. I have two sons, two daughters. I have Rich Electric, Richard Kunkel. I have Joanne Matlock. She works at the Pine Summit campground over there. Walter Kunkel, he works at Blowers. And I have my daughter Kim, and they all graduated from up here, and she lives in San Diego.
And something else about your daughters.
My daughter Joanne is also a queen. We kept this like in the family for a while. My sister, in fact, she works at the American Legion, Donna.
Your sister lives up here.
Yes.
Donna who?
Donna Kelso.
She works, of course. Yeah, that's right.
Works at the Legion.
We all had fun. She was a queen also?
Yes.
I didn't know that. I forgot it. I'm probably old. Yeah. I forgot. That's right, she was.
We've always enjoyed Oktoberfest up here. So
it was your sister and you.
And my daughter, Joanne.
But you're the only world one.
Yes. I'm the only one that carried the 21.
Yeah. But your daughter and your sister.
Mm-hmm.
They were both the Oktoberfest queens for stein carry. That's it? Only two of them?
Mm-hmm.
That's not anymore. They were going to come today, but they were busy with their royal family, so they didn't come.
My daughter Joanne would like to have been here, but she's still in Paris. She's over in Europe.
Uh-huh. Good for her. She's having a good time.
I hope so. Her and my oldest daughter. It was a sister's thing.
How nice.
So they did it.
Yes.
I'm proud of them. They're very successful young ladies.
Uh-huh. When was your first visit to Big Bear?
1969.
And
we came up, and I said, this has got to be the place where I'm going to raise my children.
Did you come up for the Oktoberfest? No.
No. We came up. My mom and dad, well, actually, my sisters and her husband owned a cabin out in off Shea Road.
Okay.
And my mom and dad bought it, and I decided to move up. I moved into their cabin with my four kids.
That's wonderful. And I loved you. I loved her dad. I knew her dad for many years, and he was one of the loveliest people in my life. And your mother is still a pretty lady and very active, yeah.
She is very active.
Very active. I enjoy always when I see her. Okay, now, what else do we need to know about Bonnie Kelso?
Well, I'm Andrew's boss. No.
This is true.
I work at Pine Knot Concessions over here at Pine Knot Landing.
The one at the bottom by the post office.
You got it.
Okay. Oh, do you? See, I know
it.
Her for years. I know she worked there. I didn't know you worked there. But you have been in so many. You were with the Emblem Club, which is no more, correct? Which
right,
is a sad
right.
thing.
Yes. It is a sad thing.
You were with them for a long time.
Right.
Yeah. I hated to see it go belly up, but hey, things happen, you know.
Yes.
So your children all went to school here?
Mm-hmm. And all my children went to college.
That's wonderful.
They all graduated from college.
Great.
I have six grandchildren.
Well, should we tell her to name them?
Yes, I think so.
You'd best, because let me tell you, I got a letter today from mine. You saw that one. You better name them, because they're going to be angry with you.
Uh-oh. I have Devin, Zach, Cammy. Richard. And then I have Eric Matlock, who's a great in sports. And my boys are all good in Pop Warner football. And then I have two little girls, Brittany and Hannah.
That takes care of six. I was counting. That's wonderful. Yeah. They've got a nice grandmother and a great-great-grand, and a perfect great-grandma, right? Which is your mother.
Yeah.
And what else? Do you work 5 days a week, 6 days a week?
Well, during the season, I work six.
What do you do in the winter?
Oh, there's lots to do. Lots.
Isn't that the truth? We can find some.
Lots to do, especially at a boat landing.
Yeah. Oh, is there?
We need to get everybody ready, all the paperwork, all the insurance in place, everything, all the billing, all the, there's a lot.
And by that time, it's spring again, ready to open up, right?
Yes.
That's wonderful.
And then we go again, and I love it.
Good. How long have you been there?
This is the best job I've ever had. 3 years.
3 years. Good. Mm-hmm. That's wonderful. Okay, shall we shift over to the present queen, Andrea Bill? Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
On being the 2006, whatever they called you, queen.
Oktoberfest queen. Yay!
You're too young to be a captain on a ship.
Oh, I'm older than you may think. I'm 31.
Don't you just dislike her? There is nobody 31, right, Michelle? No such thing. Oh, that's wonderful. Now, you heard what she did?
Absolutely.
Now it's your turn.
Oh, great.
And you can talk to that camera if you want to talk to the people, or you can talk to me and her, whichever makes you comfortable.
Thank you very much. Well, I was born in Newport Beach, California, and I still actually have a home in Mission Viejo right now. My mom and my sister live down there. My mom is Martha, and she was there when I got crowned.
Oh, how nice.
Yes, she came. She comes up as much as she can. We share a place up here for the summer.
You've been in Big Bear how long?
Since June.
And she won? September. 4 months, and you picked those? Oh, my lead. She cheated somewhere along the line.
Been practicing.
Yeah, I guess.
I enjoy it. And I went to University High School, which is in Irvine, and then Cal State Fullerton, graduated with a business degree, two of them, one in marketing, and then one in finance as well, and figured out exactly what I didn't want to do. So then I went traveling.
Good. That's the best thing, isn't it? Traveling? That's wonderful.
I think that it opens your mind to
so
many different experiences in the world.
Makes you appreciate the United States, our home.
It does. It truly is your experiences that make you rich, not any possessions that you own. That's the
true.
Greatest
sisters,
thing.
Brothers?
I have an older sister. Her name is Tammy.
And she Tammy? Well, you just said she lives with your mother. Pay attention, Nancy.
She lives very close. I call it the Bermuda Triangle. We all live within about 3 miles of each other down in South Orange County. So it's nice. I don't get to see them very often, but like I said, my mom comes
just
up here.
Just a couple hours. Yeah. You can go down, they can come up.
I'm pretty much here all the time.
So what are you going to do when they anchor the ship or whatever?
That's a very good question. We've been brainstorming, and if you have suggestions, then I'm wide open.
Oh, I see. You haven't got anything already.
She's available.
Not yet.
Well, there you go. Put her to work.
Just been helping off in the office right now, just doing the winterizations of the boat. And we are still running on the weekends, on Saturdays and Sundays primarily.
Oh, are you? What are the hours that you run this? Sierra Belle, is it?
Yeah. We run every 2 hours, basically at 10, 12, 2, 4, and we do private bookings for bar mitzvahs, weddings, ice cream socials, all sorts of
things. Just drunken parties, whatever.
Pretty much. We try and keep the drunkenness to a lull, but it's inevitable.
They don't have to worry about driving.
Exactly.
That's wonderful.
I love it. I really do. I've been so
blessed. Your first visit to Big Bear was in June, and you stayed?
No, I came up when I was younger. I used to go skiing very, very often.
Oh, of course. You're probably a good skier.
I enjoy it. Very much, very much so.
Well, there's openings at the ski resorts.
Yeah.
Takes care of the winter months.
I'm trying.
Good.
We'll see what happens. I'm open to opportunity, but definitely intending on staying.
Well, as pretty as you are and as talented you are, you're not going to have any trouble.
Thank you, folks.
I don't think so. They're probably clamoring out there. How can we get a hold of this girl?
The Sierra Belle.
That's it. Go to the Sierra Belle. And what else do we need to know about you?
I love diving. Scuba diving is my biggest thing. That's how actually I got into driving boats.
Where did you scuba dive the most or like the best?
The best would be the Galapagos.
Ah, I bet. I've never been there.
Oh, it was Amazing. Uh-huh. Absolutely amazing. And the most was New Zealand. I lived in New Zealand for a few years.
I understand they have. I was there once, but I'm not scared. Not whatever the scuba diving. But I imagine they do have a lot of nice reefs and stuff.
Oh, it's so diverse. I mean, you drive 45 minutes, and it's a totally completely different topography. It's both above and below the water. It's amazing.
And that's it. Scuba diving.
Scuba diving and do underwater photography. That's my number one passion in my life. That and my cat. I have no children, but I do have a cat.
What's the cat's name?
Her name is Tonga, like the island. Uh-huh. It is after the Polynesian god of the sea that is supposed to protect anybody that travels above, upon, or within the sea.
Where have your travels been, just briefly? I mean, where have you been? You know, if you had to name five places that you went to.
I did an exchange program in Europe, in Italy.
Did you?
And then once I graduated college, I went through Fiji, Australia, New Zealand. Lived in Belize for a year when I worked on a boat there. Went to Cayman,
adventurous.
Catalina.
Good for you.
Yes, and driving boats and teaching diving.
You did like something. Wasn't she in charge of the boat to Catalina for a while?
Yes,
did I get the wrong information?
No, that is correct.
Right?
I drove the yellow submarine, the glass bottom boat.
How long was that?
I worked there two seasons, but it was only about 6 months. I was there winter. I
prefer
the winters.
Did you like it?
I do, but it. I like the winters there. It's a lot quieter.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I would imagine.
And for me, that's lobster season. So that's when I get to go diving. So that's
that's wonderful. That is great. You haven't given me any high signs yet, have you, sweetheart? No? Okay. Now, these two ladies here, believe it or not, and I'm not exaggerating, these are very heavy. Don't let anybody tell you they're not. They weigh 5 pounds full with, is this the line here for the water? 5 pounds. And I have one here, and it almost takes two hands to lift it up, and there's nothing in it. Now, are you going to, later on, we're going to have, Andrea's going to show us how she did it, whether she cheated or not. But these are huge. Now, obviously, if you drop one, it's going to splatter, correct? I mean, water and glass.
Yes.
This is solid. I mean, it's not plastic.
Actually,
folks.
Those bounce pretty good.
Do they? You should know.
Thankfully.
Yes. We've had some girls drop them, and they just bounce.
Now, well, they're so thick. They made in Germany, are they?
You know, I don't know.
I don't either. It says something on there, but I don't think that's Germany, no.
Now, they get it probably from the Budweiser Brewery or
but they are heavy. Wine, what is this? Warsteiner? How do you pronounce that? Warsteiner?
Warsteiner.
Because life is too short to drink cheap beer. Now, if you drank one of this, what is this, a quart?
Oh, at least. A liter.
A liter.
Mm-hmm. Which is
a little more than a quart. Oh, you would get snockered. You wouldn't be able to pick it up anymore, would you?
First time I won carrying 19, and I thought I'd be such a smarty pants, and I tried drinking 19.
And you're still here to talk about it.
Thankfully.
I gained 50 pounds in 3 weekends. Everybody kept drinking.
Little straws.
Do you still drink beer?
No.
You like beer?
Not very often.
I just am amazed when they showed me this afternoon, how heavy they are. I mean, if somebody was to conk you with this, you'd be out for weeks.
Yeah, I try to avoid
it
that.
It is heavy, folks. It is not plastic. It is glass, very thick. Heavy glass. And if you hold two.
See, and she holds 6 in each hand.
Get out. You're going to do that for us?
Absolutely.
Did you bring 12?
I brought 13, so you can see the exactly.
Oh, you're going to show that.
How she
JR,
carried.
You better be nice to this young lady because she's got mean arms, boy. Whew. Now, you don't have big arms, though. How
Just
come?
Solid. Just solid. I did a lot of sports growing up.
Oh, my Lance. Did you try to pick up two of these, Michelle?
No.
They're huge and heavy.
I picked up one.
Pick up two. It's a good bus builder, which I don't need. But they are huge. Absolutely heavy, 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 heavy. Hi. Well, with that note, we're going to talk some more about Oktoberfest and all of this contest here with my royal family today. The queen of the world champion Bonnie Kelso on my left, and the current queen, Stein Carrier for Big Bear Lake Oktoberfest, Andrea Bill. Support our sponsors. Excuse me. Come on board and come right back.
Village Trading Post, Big Bear's premier shopping location, invites you to check out our full line of clothing and unique gifts. We feature fine manufacturers like Woolridge, Bongo, Levi's, and more. Whether you need shirts, socks, jackets, or blankets, Village Trading Post has you covered. Our huge showroom features thousands of unique gift ideas. Don't miss the Harley-Davidson's gift section and our large selection of leather goods. Located in the heart of the village, we've got something for everyone.
Some guy, born a long time ago, claims to be God, does a few miracles, preaches a few sermons, heals a few diseased people, walks on water. Then he gets himself killed on purpose, sacrifice for our sin. Then 3 days later, he comes back to life again. You're crazy.
Up here in Big Bear, we're famous for our hospitality. You know, having friends over for parties like birthdays, barbecues, holidays. It's way of life in Big Bear. Hey, let's face it, our friendly locals love to party. But the biggest damper to ever happen to a party has to be a plumbing problem. For example, in the situation you see here, a young local lady is having a combination Vegas night wine tasting party when, at the blink of an eye, the somewhat elderly butler, who seems a little on the shaky side, accidentally drops an expensive bottle of Chateau Lafite into the sink and down the garbage disposal. What do? You call Tom Moffitt Plumbing. Tom has the know-how, parts, and equipment to solve all of the plumbing problem disasters you may have, be it garbage disposal, faucets, toilets, water heaters, plug drains, stop waste, or frozen pipes. Tom can save the day or the party for you. His friendly attitude, it's famous throughout the valley. So next time you have a problem with your Chateau Lafite, call Tom Moffitt. Tom and his feet will be happy to help you out. 878-8030.
Prudential Real Estate, we've teamed up with Yahoo to create a more powerful way to find a home. Yahoo Real Estate connects you to Prudential Real Estate offices with more than 1 million properties online and markets from coast to coast. You'll find more facts and photos to help you explore the properties you like. And when you're ready, you're one click away from a Prudential Real Estate sales professional who can make home buying and selling a snap. Prudential Real Estate and Yahoo together, the perfect way to find the perfect home.
For the best Mexican food in Big Bear, it's the Nora Cantina, featuring our local favorites like fabulous fajitas, fresh tamales, and Big Juan burrito, over 5 pounds. Open from 11 to 9, 7 days a week. Sonora Cantina also has a full-service bar, margaritas, and specialty drinks. Come in for a quick lunch or a full dinner. Takeout available. Located at 41144 Big Bear Boulevard, next to the Old Country Inn.
Here at Medical Arts Pharmacy and Medical Supplies, we understand that your time is valuable, and that's why we're a good neighbor pharmacy. At Medical Arts Pharmacy, we'll walk you through your purchase step by step to help find out what your insurance will cover and make sure you know how to utilize your new medical equipment. We also offer a complete pharmacy with prescriptions, mastectomy prosthetics, diabetic supplies, custom orthotics, and much more. Whether it's power chairs, scooters, or wheelchairs, come to Medical Arts Pharmacy. We take the time.
It's kind of sad because
we're visiting, folks. Welcome back to Voices of the Valley today with my royal court. It's not a royal court, it's just royalty that I have today. The Queen Stein Carrier, the world's champion on my left here, is Bonnie Kelso. Queen Bonnie Kelso, is that what they call you? Queen Bonnie Kelso? And on my right here is another pretty lady, Andrea Bill, who's 2006. Stein carrying queen, right, at Oktoberfest.
Correct.
And this girl's no bigger than a minute. Doesn't that make you angry?
Wait till I stand up. I'm tall.
You may be tall, but you're built like a
Thank you, I think.
We were talking during the commercial about these lovely outfits, dresses, outfits. What do you call them? Costumes?
Dirndls.
You call them what?
Dirndls.
Dirndls?
That's the German name for the dress. And you can get on eBay and find them if you're lucky.
They're not cheap, folks.
No. a dress and a blouse and an apron usually runs around $300, $350.
And can you launder them yourself, or yes. is it a dry cleaning?
Throw them in the wash. You don't dry them. Just shake them out and hang them up.
Now, I asked earlier, how come you have an apron and she doesn't?
Some prefer aprons and some prefer not to have aprons.
It's optional then, whatever they want. Why didn't you want an apron?
I was tight enough already.
She didn't want anybody to see how skinny she was. You put it on, it'd add weight, right?
I had to have my mom help me.
Oh, that's interesting. Now, along with the women's outfits, I noticed none of them are very long. They don't go to the ground, floor length. Ankle length.
But they do, they are coming out with tea length. And they are T-length skirts.
Like half a leg, but there's nothing really to the ankle, is it? No long dresses.
No, I haven't seen any.
Uh-huh. That's not one of their customs, obviously.
I like the way they're coming out with the vests. You know, Mill Creek, I don't know if I can say
that. Yes, you can. Oh. He's a sponsor here, yes.
Mill Creek Trading Post just got in some vests that are exquisite.
Really?
Absolutely exquisite. You could put them with a green skirt and stand out.
The embroidery work, I wish you people could see it. Go to the Oktoberfest and look at some of these outfits or these costumes that these girls have. The needlework and just beautiful.
Now Monica has every year with her waitresses when they come in apply for jobs. Uh-huh. If they're hired, she actually has drindles or costumes for every one of them. It's amazing. She's accumulated. She's bought on eBay. And again, if you're in the Queen Contest, we can find you a costume. We'll come up with a costume for you. So that isn't an expense. You have fun. And all of these are laundered.
They look, I don't know, it's a beautiful cotton type polyester thing. It's just beautiful. It doesn't wrinkle, does it?
No.
No, I noticed that. How about your footwear? Is there a specific thing for feet, special shoes or something, to make this drindle, whatever, complete?
No.
There isn't?
Just wear whatever is comfortable.
Mm-hmm. They don't have like a short boot or something that's part of it?
No. A long time ago, we used to wear the white boots up to the knees. But I think we've all got away from that and gone to just comfortable shoes.
Comfortable shoes. Of course, if you're going to... Mm-hmm. How far do you have to...
Okay.
How far do you have to walk with all of this stuff from, 2 feet, 10 feet?
30 feet.
30 feet.
Now, I have to tell you, the origin of the contest.
Uh-huh.
Over in Germany, you go to a table... And you'd have to pick up all their steins. Empty. Okay, and then go over to the bar, fill the steins up, pick them up, take them back to the table, and give them to everybody whose stein belongs to them.
That's how this started, probably. Mm-hmm. This is a tradition with them.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Now, the reason that the line is
she
here...
She picks that up like nothing, you know?
is when you pay for a beer... You don't mind a little foam or head, but if someone were to pick 15 of these up and spill them, you wouldn't want to pay for half of a stein.
That's right. You
want the whole thing. And that's where the contests come in over there.
This line.
Mm-hmm. Is you need to get this over to the table and to the person, and it was the waitress that got the most. And that was the original contest.
What were her tips like?
That's a good question.
It was a lot of fun over there.
And then you were over there doing this. Approximately how many would this waitress carry?
She would carry probably no less than maybe 16.
She'd have to serve 16 tables, 16 drinks?
Nancy, you got to remember, over in, like in Munich, you see how big the convention center is?
Yes.
It's like three of the convention centers in one tent. I mean, it's huge, absolutely huge. And that's why I laughed, because we do the chicken dance.
Yeah.
You know why it originated over in Germany? Because they need to get people up and moving to get that beer rolling again.
I see.
So in all those long tables, every waitress had a section, and The more you get, the more money you get as tips.
So, how long were you over there?
In 1974, I was over there 2 weeks.
But were you partaking in the contest?
Oh, sure.
You were, okay.
I went to Düsseldorf, Dortmund, Heidelberg, Munich. I went to Ritterbrau Brewery. I'm trying to think. There was quite a few breweries that I went to. And I met the president of Germany, which is the chancellor.
Wow.
He gave me the most exquisite Stein with the seal of Germany on it, and it's full-blown crystal.
Is it? Oh, it's crystal. Oh,
it's crystal.
My. I bet
and,
it's
and
gorgeous.
And we had dinner with him. We had a lovely time over there. The people were excellent. They were very, they opened their arms.
Hospitable.
I stayed in castles, which are very cold.
Yes, I know. I have been to
and,
a couple of castles.
Elsa Quinn, remember Elsa?
Yes.
She was my interpreter, which was absolutely, I was so lucky because she also had a mother over there at that time.
Uh-huh.
So we would stay with her mom and visit, have a good time, go to open air markets and see how they lived over there.
How wonderful.
It was a really good experience.
Elsa was such a lovely lady. She had a beautiful shop here. For your newcomers or your old timers, if you remember her on Pine Knot Boulevard. And she just loved everybody, and everybody loved Elsa. She was such a nice lady. You were very fortunate.
She was so much fun to travel with.
Yeah. She had
I
a travel agency,
you.
Too, remember?
Yes. We went to this one, we stayed in Hotel in der Straße, which is a hotel in the street, where the street goes right beside. When you open the door, you have to make sure you look both ways.
That's
how close that. To the street
Holy
it was.
Mackerel.
And I'm tired from going to all these breweries, so I go upstairs, and at 1 o'clock in the morning, I'm wondering where Elsa is. She is downstairs having more fun. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, here I'm supposed to be fun. And I'm pooped. She's the one that's having the fun. It was so much fun traveling with her.
That's wonderful.
She was hard to keep up with. That lady
had
the energy.
Yeah, well, she was hard to keep up with here. That woman had energy. She really did. She was such a love. Oh, and then after this contest where you carried, how many did you carry there to get to win there?
21.
21 there.
Mm-hmm. In fact, I carried 21 three times in one day, which was very hard. And
very hard, she said.
Because once is hard enough.
Yeah.
But Elsa knows how to lace the steins.
I know how. You have to kind of, I can't do it, but I know how it's done. You have to hook it up so that middle one doesn't go down, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She got to where she could lace my steins. All I had to do was look at her and she'd say, you're ready, go. And I'd just lift them up and go.
Did you psych yourself out and say, I got to get over there?
Actually, what was nice is I was lifetime honorary member of the Chamber of Commerce up here, which I think there's only like two or three of us.
Uh-huh.
And then I was an ambassador, so Jerry Lewis, our senator?
Yes.
Okay, I got a passport for being an ambassador.
Uh-huh.
So I thought to myself, oh my gosh, all this royal, treatment, I can't let anybody down.
Oh, that's one way to psych yourself, yeah.
So it was up and at 'em and over.
Did you sleep that night when they crowned you Queen of the World, Stein Carrier?
Actually, we
exhausted me.
Yeah. it was just a lot of fun.
Uh-huh.
And then getting ready to get going again. It was, I wish I could tell you
all
the different places that we went to carry. Ritterbrau Brewery was our last. They had all the steins ready for us.
Is that all
you,
like this?
No.
No?
All of them were different over there. So it was quite unusual to have to carry because I had the glass steins. I also had the ones that are the gray steins.
Pewter?
And they were all different. So, but I carried six in each hand, and then we just laced them and made sure the handles were right. Up and at them, and over I went.
But weight-wise, is pretty much like this?
Pretty much the same.
Mm-hmm. Holy cow, see what you got to look forward to.
Look up to.
Holy mackerel. Oh. Well, on that note, we're going to go to a commercial. And I think when we come back, in fact, I know when we come back, this lovely lady over here, Andrea Bill, she's going to carry how many?
13.
Oh, do come back. Support our sponsors, but do come back because we're in for a heck of a show. Thank you.
You work hard for your money. To help you get the most from your hard work, you'll need a friend at the bank. First Mountain Bank, two locations make it easy. Best with the best. I'm glad I did.
Prudential Real Estate, we've teamed up with Yahoo to create a more powerful way to find a home. Yahoo Real Estate connects you to Prudential Real Estate offices with more than 1 million properties online and markets from coast to coast. You'll find more facts and photos to help you explore the properties you like. And when you're ready, you're one click away from a Prudential Real Estate sales professional who can make home buying and selling a snap. Prudential Real Estate and Yahoo together, the perfect way to find the perfect home.
Hi, this is Olivia. Welcome to the Barnstorm Restaurant.
For great food and a great atmosphere with great views, come to where your friends are, the Barnstorm Restaurant. This longtime Big Bear favorite offers a wide variety of menu items like succulent steak and lobster combination, rack of lamb, a Big Bear favorite, the fish and chips with award-winning coleslaw, and much more. Whether you choose dinner from 5 to 9 p.m. any day but Tuesday, or breakfast and lunch 7 days a week from 7 to 3, the Barnstorm Restaurant provides freshly prepared food made from the best ingredients. All meats and fish are fresh, not frozen. And the prices are so affordable.
Hi, this is Zina. We look forward to seeing you soon at the Barnstorm Restaurant.
For reservations, delicious and stylish catering for your party or event, or orders to go, call the Barnstorm Restaurant at 585-9339.
Thanks for visiting the Barnstorm Restaurant.
Hello, Big Bear. I'm your host, Nancy Kennedy, with Voices of the Valley. Join me and my very informative guests every Tuesday and Thursday at 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. See you then.
As a part of Bear Valley Community Healthcare District, the Family Health Center is a rural health clinic providing health care for area families. The Family Health Center offers well baby care, newborn checkups, both infant and pediatric immunizations, and general health care for all members of the family. We also offer the Mothers on Mountain program for high-quality prenatal care. Staffed by a physician medical director, licensed nurse practitioners, and a physician assistant. For general health care for all members of the family, it's the Family Health Center on Summit Boulevard, across from the hospital.
Come over, baby, the whole family's at the pool and barn. Who's barn? Your barn, my barn. Come on over, honey, there's always a party at the barn.
Who's barn? Your barn, my barn.
We ain't faking, a million things to do at the barn. Woo! Shake it, baby, shake. Have a drink at the bar. Shake it, baby, shake. Bowl a few games. Shake it, baby, shake. Eat at the snack bar. Shake.
Hi, folks. We're back to Voices of the Valley. Welcome back. My guests today are royalty, as I said earlier. Bonnie Kelso on my left here is the world champion Stein carrier for the Oktoberfest. And the young lady that you're going to see carrying how many?
13
Steins. She's not going to go quite the 30 feet that's required, but there is a distance. How many feet would you say this is, JR?
About 15,
maybe. About 15 or 20 feet. She's going to be carrying all 16. That's how she won the title.
Not quite right
yet. He's not. Well, you see how he is? He is so slow, and he's a young man. No, but we are going to have her, Andrea Bill, who is the current Queen Stein carrier here at our Oktoberfest. She's going to carry 16. I can't bear to carry those two.
It is heavy.
I think JR is kind of focusing on her now.
We're good.
Are you ready? So do you want to just pick them all up, and are we going to see how she's doing it?
We can see somewhat.
Yeah. So it's all yours, Andrea.
Sounds great.
Start picking up your you're 16 whatever. Remember, folks, these are not. Is that 16 there?
No, that's 13.
That's 13.
And that's what she carried to win the queen contest. See how you have to
now
put them down?
Now, how in the world did you get all that together?
It's all about how you position them, relace them, and as Lonnie says.
Was her hands through every one?
She carries 12.
Carry basically six in each hand. And then the odd man out, you kind of got to lock him in there just to make sure he doesn't fall. And the biggest thing is pushing him together and in.
But now, folks have got to realize these are empty ones. They look easy, but they're not. It's hard to carry, too. And those are full of beer.
When yes, we did it with water. We were going to do it with beer, but we finished a little bit early.
But it's still the the weight of the liquid is
exactly
in there.
The
how much does that weigh, do you think, Bonnie?
That was 60 pounds, I believe.
Yeah,
right?
They're 5 pounds apiece. Yeah, 65 pounds for 13 cents.
Do you want to be next year? Do you want to carry them? All right, Michelle, how about you?
Yeah.
Don't look at me because I can barely pick up.
We're
two.
Always looking for contestants. Always.
Okay.
Now in August, we'll start practicing again, and all the girls have to do is call the convention center, and they'll get a hold of me or call Pine Knot Landing. We'll go out to Wyatt's. I'll pull out the Steins again, and we'll start practicing.
There you go, Michelle.
And you can
you
find
can do
out
it, I'll
if,
bet you.
If you can do it, and you can have fun. You can, we'll be carrying them out in, where in the grassed area.
Uh-huh. So,
so
when they
even,
fall, they
yeah,
don't break.
Even if they fall and you can see how we do it and just come out and have fun.
Now, I have another question. Is this only for women? Do they have such a thing? Oh, the men hold that out,
hold
don't
the
they?
Steins out. But the women have
for how long? They're cowards. They're weaklings. They should be doing this, don't
I
you
agree.
Think?
Yay.
I mean, what do they hold one? Do you hold two or what?
No,
the
they
men?
Just hold one out and see how long they can hold
they
it
They just
up.
Lock their arm in.
Mm-hmm. I haven't seen any do it more than 4 minutes. 4 minutes, maybe.
Yeah, right around there.
Yeah, that's
really?
About the max. But, I mean, there is a record like 14 minutes, you know, that someone uh-huh. did way back, way back. But
now, pick up your beautiful trophy. This thing has got to be how
small.
Many feet?
Oh, gosh, three?
Absolutely.
Did you say two and a half?
Can you zero in on her trophy?
Isn't that
no,
pretty?
No, you can't. See, I'm making him work today.
She also gets $500 for winning.
Is that all? For all that $500? I would demand more. Oh, that's a good picture. That is beautiful, kid. That is absolutely gorgeous. Now, the lady on the top, turn that around, would you, Andrea, so I can see the lady. How come she's not holding a stein? You would
yeah.
be holding a stein.
That's a brilliant question.
Wouldn't you?
Maybe next year. It's a good suggestion.
Yeah. Oh, and it says Oktoberfest Queen 2006 Big Bear Lake. You're to be commended.
Oh, thank
just,
you kindly.
I
thank you very much.
I had picking up two empty ones.
Yeah, now a lot of the girls, once they get up to the table this year, they got really excited.
The table, the end of the table, the beginning?
Beginning.
Uh-huh.
And when you lift, you have a tendency to open your hands, and that odd man fell.
You mean arms, you pulled your arms.
Yeah, well, see, you hold them together with your hands. And as they were walking, instead of holding and locking, especially with your elbows, they were up like this and then held it, and that's how come
they
we
lost.
Eliminated so many, is because they dropped the stein or they lost too much water.
Oh, be darned. Oh, it's. Do you know when this all started? The year what they started with this? People
well, you
serving
know, the
in
first
Germany?
One that was Pam LaPlante. Plant. She was the first queen, and I think she carried.
Where was she?
Summit. I believe, Summit.
Oh, here, locally?
Mm-hmm.
What I meant, excuse me, what I meant was, how did this start in Germany? I know the girls served everybody and they had to carry all these steins, but when did we sort of, we adopt it as a contest? Or am I not making
oh,
myself
yeah,
clear?
Yeah, I don't know when we did.
It's a good question.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, when did they start having a stein-carrying contest in America is what I'm wondering. Do they have it at the other Oktoberfest?
Oh,
know?
Sure.
They do?
I've been to probably over 100 Oktoberfests.
In California.
Wow.
In California. Laguna has a nice one. Old World. Gosh, I can't even name. I mean, LA has an Oktoberfest. Mm-hmm. All the way up to Solvang had a really nice Oktoberfest.
Oh, I bet they do, yeah. You know,
all the way up Santa Barbara, all of them have, and they all are very nice. They invite me.
Well, of course, the Queen.
Sun City has a really
Get
nice
out,
one.
Those old people in Sun City.
They know how to party.
How many do they carry?
They,
1.5 people.
But everybody, all the way through from New York, I've been to La Crosse, Wisconsin, Denver, Colorado, up to Little America, Wyoming, up to Ontario, Canada has a really big one.
I'll bet they do, yeah. But nobody's beat you.
No.
Not with that word, W-O-R-L-D, that says it all, does it not? Mm-hmm. And you're here with us. My little Bonnie that I knew when she was that skinny, and yes. So was I. That's wonderful. Oh, we're so honored to have you.
And you just better get busy.
We're going to have to train her.
Need to keep
Next
practicing.
Year she could carry, what, 18?
Well, no, once you win, you can't do it again. Unless you challenge the world. And then the world champion, I am 21, so she would have to carry 22 to win the title. I've had a couple of girls try.
Keep going.
And they just can't seem to get them across or get them up. Or it's
Do you have a secret for doing that other than that holding it?
No.
Just the strength, huh? Mm-hmm. Holding all that. Do your hands hurt afterwards?
I broke my tailbone, so I have nerve issues anyway, so. Yeah, the day after I still had.
It hurts?
It doesn't hurt, it's just numb.
It's sore. Yeah, from like when you use muscles, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The most you're hurting is either back here, because if you see the girls carrying, they get so intense.
Yeah, and that all connects, of course. Mm-hmm.
Or lower back.
Right.
That's a come when they practice, I show them how to. You don't stand up and then lift your arms. You pull
you
them to
down,
you
I noticed
and lift it. With yeah. your legs. Mm-hmm. I teach them that, and I teach them how to lace.
Lace, so that's your...
That's how the handles go inside each other to hold everything up. Because as you get more and more and more, you need to know where to stick those handles. Mm-hmm. So when you pull your hands in,
they kind
everything
of lock,
stays
They lock there. Together.
Mm-hmm. How long did you practice before you entered the contest?
Oh, the first week, I barely made it there. I had a 4 o'clock tour, I had no practice. Yeah. And then the next week, Bonnie was kind enough to sit with me for about 10-15 minutes. Mm-hmm. We sat down and we did, we practiced with 13, 14, and 15. 13 was the hardest for me. 14 and 15 was a little easier.
I mean, how long before you entered the contest? A week, 2 weeks, what?
Mm-mm. 1 week,
yeah.
Oh my gosh. You hear that, Michelle? She practiced a week, so there is hope for you.
Yeah.
I bet she could. You know, I bet she could. She looked like the kind that would do it.
Definitely try.
Why don't you try these before we go, and if you break one, you have to buy it.
It's fun, if nothing else. I definitely encourage everyone to try it at least.
Now, she cannot enter next year.
No, she's done. She'll be part of the royal court. At the Oktoberfest, forever and ever.
But can she practice between now and then, and maybe beat your record?
I would
There's
love it.
There's nothing to stop her from practicing.
No, not at all.
Oh, okay.
All they have to do is call me. Mm-hmm. We'll go out to the convention center, pull the steins out.
And when she thinks she's ready, she's got 23, then she calls you.
Might be a long wait.
21. Nobody's carried more than 21. Mm-hmm. Even those girls in Germany didn't do it?
Mm-mm. The closest anyone's come was Polly. She carried 19.
Uh-huh. But
and then Pat Boring tried it 1 year.
Yes.
And she, I believe, carried 19 over. But at 20, she dropped. And then I went to 21 without going to 20. Now, you have to remember,
Smart
when we were in the tent, we didn't have rules like we do now.
Uh-huh.
And the rules are for a reason, so you don't get hurt. You don't.
Yes, yes.
You know, and you do it progressive. Back then, Diana York,
yes,
she was my lacer, and she walks up to the table. And I went down to get him, and I pulled my arms around, and I had a hole here and a hole here. And she looked at me, and she goes, well, you know, pull your arm in. And I said, no, just put another stein there. And she thought I was nuts. But see, I had always had one child on one hip and one on the other. So
I told you she cheated.
Practice.
110 was okay. And then I got him up and over, and I looked at Diana and I said, "And what's the big deal?" And she started laughing, and then they counted the steins, and it was 21.
Caesar.
That was the
secret. On that note, we're going to practice during this commercial. Mm-hmm. Is this our last commercial? No, it is. This is our last commercial, so we have to be winding down. Do stay with us, and we're going to have some more talk about my royal court today, Bonnie Kelso and Andrea Bill. Come back and support our sponsors.
Loyal customers for helping.
What do we got?
Oh, Ron, we've got all kinds of old-time candies and chocolate. Ron, we've got all kinds of mountain bear and moose decor for your walls. Ron, we got bear paw slippers for everyone's bare feet. We've got Burt's Bees natural products. All kinds. We have Yankee candles in over 50 fantastic scents. Ron, we've got jams, jellies, and salsa. The best in Big Bear. We've got loads of vintage signs and thermometers. We've got red union suits for everybody in the family. Upstairs, it's Christmas year-round, Ron. Remember, Bear Mountain Trading Company. We're open 10 to 5 every day. So come on up Moon Ridge Road to 42646 Moon Ridge Road. We're not in the village and not to be missed. Come on up Moon Ridge Road, or you'll really be sorry.
Folks, here is one electrician that I really recommend. John Frazee is his name, and he does new construction, remodels, room additions, troubleshooting, service panel upgrades, and even 220 for jacuzzis, stoves, and dryers. He also does landscape lighting, ceiling fans, and so much more. And he offers discounts to seniors. John's available 7 to 7, Monday through Saturday. Frazee Electric is your Big Bear electrician, so give him a call at 585-2500, and he will call you back.
Thank you for coming back to Voices of the Valley with my royalty today. I am so honored to have you, Bonnie Kelso, the world champion's Beer Stein carrier for Oktoberfest, and then Andrea Bill, 2006 Queen Stein carrier. Oh, you make it look so easy. But we're going to get Michelle to go train. We have 7 minutes, do we?
More than that. Yeah, about 7.
About 7. He doesn't know how to tell time. people can come out to the Oktoberfest and meet you girls, right?
Yes, please.
Yes, we're there.
Yes. What are you going to try to get, people to
sign
up?
Yeah, we help with the contests out there. There's Stein Holding, Beer
Stein. Stein Holding, what is this now?
That's the guys holding the Beer Stein, Holding. And then they have a new one, a pretzel eating one this year, which is fun.
It's very comical.
To see the guys trying to eat pretzels on their knees. It is a cute.
Well, what do they do? Do they dunk them in beer, just eat pretzels, see how many they can eat?
With their hands behind their back, they have to eat them off a string, and it's like bobbing for apples.
Oh, for heaven's
sake. It's funny. You have to see it. And then they have the chicken dance. We go out there and the burger dance.
What in the world is the burger dance? I bet.
Yes. You know, over in Europe, we introduced them to McDonald's, Pizza Hut, Burger King. Those are the three chains over there. So in Europe, they made a song. It's called the Burger Dance. And it's, you have to come out. It's fun. It gets you out there and it gets you moving a lot. They have great bands. They got German band. They have the Express band this weekend. Well, actually through the rest of the Oktoberfest.
How many? Two more weekends, correct? Uh-huh. Two more?
Three.
Three?
All the way to the 28th.
That's the day we go to daylight. That's a Saturday or a Sunday?
It's a Saturday. Well, Saturday's the last day.
And then the next day is daylight saving. That's what it is. Yeah, okay.
And we're real fortunate. The Big Bear Cloggers are coming out this weekend.
Really?
They have more energy.
Look at her. Gosh. She's got the strength. They have the energy.
Yes.
It's exciting.
And they're good. And it's a new club formed. And to see them dance, it's a lot of fun. It's they come out, they do a very nice show. Everybody gets into it. And we were lucky enough this year, you know, Yvonne brought the polka dots.
Yes, she's doing well. I'm so happy for
yes,
her.
Yes, yes. She, and then, we're going to have the Schutzlager or something.
The what?
Schutzlager dance group on Sunday, I believe, which is a fun group to watch because they really have the costumes and the dancing and they get audience participation. On Sunday, the kids can enjoy it. They have musical chairs for the kids.
Oh, gee.
They have a contest. They get to hold boots up with a soda pop in them.
And, That's nice. That's
great. They get the kids. Sundays is a great family day.
So and there's only one more Sunday then.
Mm-hmm. And Nancy, they have so many booths outside with mm-hmm. so many things. That
is it all
nice.
German-oriented outside, or is it just
no,
a multitude of things?
It's a multitude. They can, soap makers.
Oh, okay.
Wood carvers, a lot of jewelry, a lot of games for the kids.
So it's not all German, just the inside
just
is your Oktoberfest. I uh-huh. see. I didn't know that. I haven't been. I'm going this Sunday. I'm going to go there.
Good.
I've been told I was going there. I have to go. So I'm
going. Has great food. And if you don't like German food, like bratwurst or knackwurst,
which is where I fit. I'm sorry, I have nothing against
they have
German,
great
but I don't like the food.
Hamburgers, they have great, it's smoked roast beef sandwich.
That sounds good.
Oh, well, half a chicken?
As long
chicken.
As it doesn't have sauerkraut. I'm not a sauerkraut person. I'm sorry for people, but we all eat what we like.
You should try this apple strudel.
Really?
Oh, my gosh. They have like a custard sauce that they put over the apple strudel.
Ooh, that sounds good.
Oh my gosh. I gave up beer. Now I'm gaining weight on apple strudel.
That's all right. It's probably healthier. Now you girls are going to be there all day, Saturday and Sunday, or is it, am I wrong about Saturday?
No, Saturday we don't get there till about 5 because we have
it's only
work.
In the evening on Saturday.
No. You can get there noon on. They're open.
Okay, from noon till
midnight.
And that's Saturday. And then
Sunday is noon until 5:30.
So you're going to be there both those days?
We're going to try to be there. If the bell doesn't go out.
The bell?
The bell.
Oh, her.
She's the captain.
<Sarah Bell. laughs>
Okay.
And if she goes out on the weekends, I usually try to go out as her mate, her first mate.
Maybe I'll come take a ride with you one day.
Oh, you're more than
excellent.
Welcome.
Oh,
and listen to her narration.
Uh-huh.
Nancy, you'll learn so much about
the ballet. I bet I will. I've been told that. How did you learn so much? You stayed up and studied all night, right?
Well, actually, I did. Larry and Peggy had given me a bunch
yes,
of reading material.
Yes, I understand
material.
That you give a good narration.
Thank you very much.
Teach us something we don't know as long as we've been up here.
Yeah, and you know what's nice is Monica has really incorporated the buses coming up.
Oh, good.
She got 7 buses, and they go around the lake. And then they come in and they stop and they let the people go shopping for an hour.
How nice.
And then they go out there and they have lunch and then they go home. So she's not only helping the valley.
Yes.
You know, people that wouldn't get up here.
Yes.
Are up here in buses.
Especially now we've got that extra long drive because of the front way. But that's another story. Oh, that's wonderful. But I'm going to be out there Sunday. I'll be looking for you guys. I'm going to be there at 1 o'clock, I was told. So I'll be there
at
1 o'clock.
Excellent.
People tell me where I go, you know. Oh, they always tell me where I go.
Well, the Express Band will be up. They're a very good
German. They have a new band, I understand, right?
This is, the German band went home on Monday.
Oh, that's the one I was talking about. They had a German band. Where did they come from?
Germany.
They did.
And they were excellent.
Oh, okay.
None of them spoke really good English, but Monica and Hans and Erica were right there with them. Very nice group of boys.
Good.
Very nice. And they played very well. They played
German.
Eight, I think. Eight pieces.
Okay.
And they actually came from a group of 24. They have a 24-piece band.
Mm-hmm.
But over in Europe, they only get 4 weeks, 4 weeks a year off. Isn't that?
Oh, that's awful.
Isn't that tough to take?
Yeah.
And they had to go back to work.
You said they played German when I interrupted you. They played German music?
And they play American music.
They
played a lot of country, a lot of Johnny Cash, a lot of line dancing. They really enjoyed coming here. And now we're going to get the Express Band that's from Southern California. Now, they've come and they've been with us for probably, I would say, close to 20 years.
Wow.
And they're an excellent band. Good. They're very, very popular. We're very lucky to get them every year. They play rock and roll, German, country, and they get out there and they get the groups going.
Like we should get everybody to go, right?
Yes. Come out and have fun with us.
Well, I think we're going to wind down, but everybody go to the Oktoberfest, meet these two lovely ladies, these two royal, the royalty here. I have a couple of minutes. I have a new flower arrangement today that's we got from the Cedar Rosebud across the way here. They supply us with flowers. These are absolutely gorgeous, but I'm going to exchange them because as beautiful as these are, they're not as really fall, are they? And she.